Hello!
It's almost 3 o'clock, and we will be starting Get Crafty. Today we will be making some bunny ears, very quick and easy, and also some cute little bunnies. So we're gonna wait just a couple of more minutes before we get started. And while we're waiting, what we made last Tuesday or Wednesday were Fabergé eggs. I had shown some of the eggs I made. There's one. There's another one. This is one that I'm still working on. I'm adding the red glitter glue to it. Haven't quite finished it. And then these three are still drying. They're getting there. So when you make these eggs, once you get your basic colors on the egg, it really helps to add some detail. So this one, I outlined the different colors in black. It just really makes the egg pop a little bit more. And with this one, once I drew all those lines, I put some glitter glue in it, following the different directions that my lines went. And then these two, I also added glitter glue to it just to give it another dimension, and it really sparkles. I don't know if you can see it so much on the screen, but they are very sparkly. I like sparkles. And they sit on my little, that's that one, and then this one's very similar to it. It just gives the eggs another dimension. But anyway, that was Tuesday. Our projects today, you will need some heavy paper. Construction paper might work. I wouldn't use printer paper. It's probably too thin. A straight edge. I'm actually going to be using some wallpaper. A while ago, I had gone to a wallpaper store to pick up some expired or old wallpaper sample books, and usually they'll give them to you if they have any, and it's good heavy thick paper that you can use for lots of craft projects. So my bunny ears are going to be made out of this wallpaper today, but you can also just use cardstock. You could even, if you don't have cardstock, use a cereal box. Just cut open the cereal box, and it's about...
Sorry, I didn't quite catch that.
It's about as heavy as cardstock is. Of course, you're going to have to paint it or color it or something, but it would work. So we're going to make the bunny ears. And we're going to start. I cut these in 8.5 by 11 inch size. We're going to start by drawing two bands, straight pieces of our paper. I'm just going to do the width of my ruler. It's probably a little bit more than an inch wide. I wouldn't go too much more than an inch and a half. It just makes the band too wide if you do. So draw your lines. That makes it easy so that I don't have to measure. just doing the width of the straight edge. And then I'm going to take some scissors and cut those off. Now, I have a very big head, so two strips for me wouldn't work. I would need three or two and a little bit extra for my head. But what we're going to do once these are cut is overlap them and glue them together. Make sure if you have two-sided, you get the right sides together. Just about a quarter of an inch is all we need. So we're going to do that. And just put a little glue. You can use a glue stick if you want. Any kind of glue will work. And I'm going to put those together. And then we're going to glue the other edge together. Now, like I said, this one's going to be too small for me. It sits on the top of my head. So I could probably wear it, maybe. But if I wanted it more comfortable, I'd make it bigger. Gotta open the glue to have it come out. Oops. And my other end came apart, so we're going to re-glue that again. Lots of times when I have to glue things, I will use paper clips to hold it until it dries. So that can be drying while we make the ears.
You're coming in much better.
So there's my band, and we'll make the ears now. Just set that aside. So this smaller piece we're going to use for the inside of the bunny ears, and the full size piece we're going to use for the ears themselves. So first thing I want you to do is fold it in half. Since mine has a right side and a wrong side to it, I'm putting the right sides together. That way, any lines I make won't show. Now, we have it folded in half. I want you to fold it in half again. Just pinch it a tiny bit at the very top. That will show you where the center of the paper is. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the folded end first, but I have to draw the shape of the bunny ear. So I'm going to start where that little teeny pinch was and bow out and down and then in just a little bit at the bottom. This is what I drew. Hopefully you can see that. And then what I'm going to do is cut that side. So we're just making a bunny ear shape. There's one side of our bunny ear. Now with this piece that you cut off, you're gonna flip it over and put it down on your paper, and we're going to trace it. The part where we cut, we're going to trace. I don't know if you can see that. So I'm just setting it on the paper and taking my pen, and this way my bunny ears will be the same on both sides. Got a little bump in there where my finger was, but that's okay. So there's the other side of my bunny ear, and I'm going to cut that off. Now your bunny ears should look similar on both sides. There's the ears. But now the bunny ears are usually pinkish on the inside. If you want to use a different color paper, you can. I used pink cardstock for the inside of those ears. But I'm just going to use my leftover paper from the band that I made for my head. And I'm going to make the ears the exact same way, except for I need them narrower than this one. So that's why this paper is fine. And then I'm going to color it because I want them to be pink. So the same way I did it before, fold it in half. You're going to want it to be slightly shorter than the big ear. So it's the same size right now, but we're not going to make it quite as big. Once again, fold it at the top just a little bit and pinch it so you know where the center of your piece is. And then I'm going to draw another bunny ear. But this one's going to be a little bit shorter. So that's how long my bunny ear is this time. It goes from the center, down near the edge, and then back towards the middle. So I'm going to cut that off. And then once again, I'm going to take the piece that I just cut off. Make sure you keep the top at the top. Line it up with my other piece. And then draw this one. And then cut it out. So those are going to be the inside of my ears. Mine, I want pink, so I'm going to color them pink. You could do this before you cut it out if you wanted to. If you have another piece of paper, you can just glue it to your ear. That's how it's going to go. So, coloring. How's everybody doing? Am I going too fast? I hope not. Okay, I was able to get my camera to work better today. Amazing what coronavirus is doing for my technical abilities. Okay, there's one ear's colored. I'll color the other one. My felt pen's giving out. Oh, I forgot to show you my little chick in an egg. Oops. Let's see. He likes to poop jelly beans. I love jelly beans. I don't know if anybody else does. So when I saw that, I had to buy it. Okay, let's see. We are almost done. Okay, I hope you're up to where I am. I'm ready to glue the center of my ears into the main ear. So just put some glue on it. And turn it over and center it in your ear. There we go. One bunny ear. Almost done with the second one. Put it on the second one. There we are, two bunny ears. Now hopefully your band is dry enough that you can take off your paper clips. If you don't have paper clips and you're waiting for something to dry, you can put it down flat and put something heavy on top of it. That will help hold it. It's kind of hard to do if it's in a circle though. Oh, and that doesn't look like it's staying very well, so I think I'll put the paper clip back on it. Okay, so here's my bunny ears, and I'm just going to put them on the inside of the band. I usually put the seams, or where we glued it together, on the side, so that the front of the band is plain. And I like to glue them on the inside of the band just because then their heads kind of help hold it in place and they can start wearing it before it gets totally dry. So decide how you want your ears to go. They can go kind of sideways. They can go straight up and down. I like them kind of sideways. So figure out if you want to mark it so you know where to put the glue. You can do that. So I just held it the way I wanted it, turned it over, and marked the back of the ear so you can see that. And I'll put some glue on that. Now you don't want overflow glue, especially if your bunny's going to start wearing it right away. And then put it back on. And once again, I'm going to put some paper clips on it just to hold it until it's dry. If you're using a glue stick, it will probably dry much faster, so it won't matter. Okay. If your ear tends to fall over a lot, you can kind of make a little crease, and that will help hold it up straight. And then my other ear, I want it to be about the same. Mark it on the back. Put on some glue. There's my second ear. Oops. My bunny ears are falling all over the place. Oh no. Once again, I'm using a paper clip to help hold it till my glue dries. Folding it a little bit. Now, I like one of my bunny ears to fold over. So to do that, just take a pencil or a pen and roll the end of it. And then when you let it out, you've got a folded over ear. And then you can wear your bunny ears. Now, if this actually would go down on my head more, if I would have made the band big enough, the band would help hold the bunny ears straight up. There you go, bunny ears. So that was the easy craft for today. The next craft we're going to do are my bunnies. It's fairly easy. I have two different sizes, and you can decide which size you want to make. You're going to take your cardstock or cardboard, lightweight cardboard, and we need 7 2-inch strips. We're going to go the long way. For this smaller bunny, I did 4 strips the length of the paper, so the long way. And for this bunny, it was 7 long strips, 7 2-inch wide long strips. So if you're doing this bunny, you're going to need 2 pieces of paper for either of them. You're going to need 2 pieces of paper for either of them. For this one, 7 strips cut the long way. For this one, 4 strips cut the long way out of one paper. And then out of the other one, you're going to cut 4 the short way. Doesn't matter. It just depends if you want a taller or a smaller bunny. Okay. So go ahead and start cutting your strips. They don't have to be exactly 2 inches wide. If you want to make them 1.5 inches wide, that's fine. It's just going to be narrower than my bunny. So this is a 2-inch wide strip. 1.5 inches would work, 1 inch would work, but then it would probably fall over forward and back, maybe a little bit easier. So it's up to you. I have already cut my strips. So I have 3 short strips. I have 4, but I only need 3. And 4 long strips. We're going to start with 2 of the long strips. And these are going to make the feet, these 2 strips. So first thing, we're going to glue together about 1/4 inch the ends of the 2 strips to make 1 long strip. And then once again, paper clips to help hold it. Like I said, if you don't have paper clips, because I don't think I put that on my list, you can just put something heavy on it or just let it sit and dry. Oh, we don't need the paper clips yet, sorry. Then we're going to take 1 end of the strip and fold it over till it meets the seam of that you just glued. So this end of the strip is going to go to this end where I can see the edge of the where I glued them together, and I'm going to glue that down just no more than 1/4 inch. So put some glue on. Okay, and then same with the other side. This time, we don't have a reference to go by, but you're going to go as far as the overlap, which is now on the bottom, so you can kind of tell where it is. And another 1/4 inch fold over. So when you're done, the two end pieces we just glued are slightly apart. There's about a quarter of an inch space between the ends of the two pieces we just put on. Now I'm going to paper clip them together so that they dry. Okay, those are my feet. We're eventually going to bend them a little bit so they'll be flat on the bottom and then bowing up. But we're going to let that dry before we do that. So set those aside. So we've done our feet. Next, we're going to do the body. For the body, we're going to use one. For this one, I'm doing a short piece because I'm making the smaller bunny. If you're doing the big piece, you just take another one of your strips. And I'm just gonna overlap it about a quarter of an inch, maybe an eighth of an inch, and glue it together. And paper clip it once again. This one needs to glue really good before we work with it a little bit more. We're going to set that aside. Now we're going to do the arms of the bunny. That's this inside piece. It's really not that hard to make. It's kind of a heart shape. The body is round. The arms are going to be a heart. So we're going to take one piece of, for me, the short one, since I'm doing the smaller bunny. And we're going to overlap this piece about an inch. So can you see how far my overlap goes to about here? An inch or so. Because it fits inside the other one, that's why we need it to overlap more, or it would be too big. So glue that together. And paper clip it. Or put something heavy on it. There we go. I'm just going to leave it like this until we got all the other pieces glued, and then we'll start putting it together and make it into a heart shape. So the next part we're going to do is the head. And it's another heart-shaped piece. I'm using the small piece again. And just gluing the edges together like we did for the body. And paper clipping it. Okay, setting that one aside. We have ears we need to make now. And this is with the last two pieces of the long strips. And this one, we're gluing the edges together about a quarter or a half an inch. And paper clipping it once again. We'll make it in an ear shape in a little bit. The reason I like to do all the gluing first is because then hopefully it's stuck and fairly dry so that I can work with it. Otherwise, I have to leave my paper clips on and that gets to be kind of a pain. But you can do that if it's not sticking very well. Since I'm using regular Elmer's glue, sometimes it takes a little bit of time before that's good and stuck. Okay, so there's my ears. Right now they're just in circles. And we're going to go back to the feet. So, see how well your paper is sticking. For the feet, I'm going to go... depends on how big you want your bunny foot, but I'm going to go out about this far. And where my finger is, I'm going to fold it back and crease it. And that makes the bunny foot. Same thing on this side. I'm going to go about this far, push it down and crease it. And there's my other bunny foot. There we go. Two bunny feet ready to go. I'm going to take my paper clips off. Hopefully it's sticking good enough now that I can work with it. And we're going to take the first round circle we made for the body. And the body is just a round circle, and we're going to glue it right there on the feet. And I'm going to put the seam on the bottom seam of the feet. Put some glue with the body. And guess what? Paper clips once again. So there we are, the bunny's feet and his body. Now we're going to put the arms in. So that was the smaller circle. You can see it's just slightly smaller than the body circle. We're going to take this off. And where your seam is, we're going to fold it back. That is going to be the top of the arms. And then the bottoms, we're going to push up like that to make a heart shape. So we're going to crease that. Actually, if you fold it exactly in half and crease it, and then flip it the other direction. Now it wants to keep coming out, but just like we did for the bunny ear, we want that piece of cardboard to curl. So if we just roll it in a pen or a pencil, it will help it keep its shape a little bit more. And when we put it inside the body and glue it and put the tail underneath it, it will help hold it up. So I'm going to roll this side a little bit also. I have some comments down there. Looks like nobody's having too hard a time. Okay. Okay, so there's my bunny arms, and the bunny arms get glued to the top of the body. So I'm going to put some glue up here. and stick it in the body. And guess what? Once again, need some more paper clips. Don't worry about his arms slouching down and not making a good heart shape yet. It will come eventually. But that will be his arms when we get them to stay up. You can still work with them a little bit and bend the paper a little bit more to get them to stay up better. But there we go so far. Next, we're going to do the bunny head. So we're going to make another heart shape. So where the seam was, we're going to fold it right at the edge of that seam and fold it exactly in half. The seam part is going to be up, and we want the bottom part to be just like we did for the arms because we're making a heart. So, like I said, you can roll it on a pencil, you can just use your fingers and kind of mold that paper into kind of a round shape. This also will start taking the right shape when we glue it down. So don't worry about it too much. But there's my head. So this part, we're going to glue on top of the body, like this. Can you see that? We want a little bit of a space here where the point of the heart goes up, and it's like an upside down heart. But we need a little bit of a point there, a little bit of space at this point between the head and the body. So you can see where I'm holding it. That's where I'm going to put my glue, on the part of the heart that's the rounded part. I'm going to turn it over and add some glue. And put it back on here. And paper clip it once again. Otherwise, you got to hold it because this one won't want to stay where you want it to be if you don't paper clip it. Let's see if I can even do that. And then push that side up. And when you get it looking something like this, you'll be ready to continue with the ears. There we go. So we have the arms down here, the body, the feet, and the head. Now we need to make our ears with the last two strips. This time, where the seam is, we're going to fold it again. And then on the inside where the seam is, we're going to fold it. So we're actually, instead of making a point, we're making a flat spot. So this part right here is the part that is overlapped. And once you get that, you can pull it out, keep that flat part straight and pull it out and then crease the end. So instead of a flat piece, you get kind of a really long, skinny triangle. And that we're going to glue right near the top of the head. So put a little glue on it. Grab another paper clip. I turned mine over because this edge sticks out a little bit and I didn't want it up. So if I put it down, it won't be as noticeable. And put my paper clip on. You may want to leave just a tiny space down so that the ears aren't directly right next to each other. It's up to you. There's one bunny ear. And now I'll do the same thing with the next bunny ear. So folding it on where the overlap ends, creasing it, finding the inside where the overlap ends and folding it there. There we go. Holding that straight up and down and pulling out to the end of my cardboard for the end of the ear, increasing it. And then gluing it once again onto the top of the bunny head. There we go. And paper clipping. There. So now we have our bunny body all finished. But he needs some whiskers and a nose and some eyes. If you have Google Eyes like I used for this one, you can use those. I don't have the right size Google Eyes. I only have these big ones right now. And I don't have any pom-poms, so I'll show you some other things you can use for your bunny nose. I did happen to have a bunch of wooden hearts here. One thing with crafting, if you have to buy supplies, you usually get way more than you need. So this was from some other project years ago. And I'm just going to color this pink. If you don't have this and you don't have pom-poms, you can cut it out of a piece of the cardstock. If you have a button, if you have some buttons, you could use a button. Use your imagination. You can come up with anything. If you have cotton balls, which we're going to use for his tail, you could take a small piece of that off and maybe use a felt pen and try to color it. Lots of different things you can use for the nose. But I'm going to color my nose pink. You don't have to make it heart-shaped. You can make a ball, you can make a circle, lots of different things. If you have pink paper, you can just roll up a piece of pink paper and use that. There's my nose. And since I don't have Google Eyes, I'm actually going to take the nose. Where did I do it? And cut out. I'm going to draw the white part of the eyes. And they're going to go be glued on to the back of the nose. That's the only reason why I have the nose there. I'll show you what I do. So I put the nose down and I drew the white part of the eyes. I'm going to cut that out and glue it to the back of the nose. You don't have to make Google eyes. If you have a black button, you could just put a black button there. You know, use your imagination. Lots of different ways you can make the eyes. I'm a big fan of Google eyes. Can't seem to cut very straight today, but oh well. I'm going to have kind of different sized eyes. Put a little glue on it. So there's his eyes, but they need some pupils, and I'm just going to draw those on with a Sharpie. Oops. If you had black pom-poms and pink pom-pom, you could use those for the eyes and the nose, and just glue them together. But there's my eyes and my nose. While that's drying, I'm going to make some whiskers. So with another scrap piece of cardstock, I'm going to make whiskers. You can use pipe cleaners like this one. I don't have any white pipe cleaners here. So I'm going to make my own. This is a piece of 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, and I'm going to cut 3 narrow strips. Probably no bigger than 1/4 of an inch. They don't have to all be the exact same. And 3. There's our 3 strips. I'm just going to kind of spread them out so they're not all the same, and fold them in half. So what we're going to do is we're going to stick these whiskers in this little space on the head. So put some glue on both sides. Just, I don't know, about 1/2 inch. Try to make sure that all the pieces get a little bit of glue on them. So I put glue up to about this point, and I'm going to put it in that little piece of, and it looks kind of funny right now because they're just going straight out. But once they're in there, you can separate them. 3 pieces to one side. Remember, you folded it in half, so we're just unfolding it. And hopefully they will be glued to the inside of the bunny head. Can you see that? Whoops! You may need to use a pencil or something to make sure that they get stuck to the edges. In they go. Okay. There we are. There's his whiskers. And now his nose and eyes get glued right on top of that. I'm going to take the paper clips off that are on this edge. Hopefully it's holding good enough that I can do that. And put some, trim some of this a little bit more. Don't want the white showing on the side of the heart. Oops. Okay. So put some glue on. You can either put the glue on the whiskers and the top edge of the head. You just want, and the top edge of the body. There we go. Now I'm going to leave this. Ta-da! I'm going to leave this sitting this way so that the eyes and the nose can glue good to the little point from the head and the body. Now the only other thing we need to do, I'm actually going to put it on its front with the nose and eyes down. We're going to put in the tail. So just, my nose isn't going to stay. Bend the arms up and put your tail in the back. That will help hold his arms up. And there's his bunny tail. On the back side, there's his whiskers. There's his tail and his whiskers. And glue that in. If you don't have a cotton ball, what else could you use? Toilet paper? I know it's a hot commodity, but you could use it. You could just wad up a piece of paper, a Kleenex, lots of different things you could use. So I'm just going to put some glue on my cotton ball. Pom-poms, if you have big white pom-poms, they would work. And stick it in there. So you want the glue to be on the top and the bottom of it so that it sticks to, I have cotton balls sticking to my fingers, so that it sticks to the top or the bottom of the arms and the top of the feet. And because my nose is made out of wood and heavy, it doesn't want to stay yet because my glue's not dry. But it will eventually. And there you have it. Your bunny is finished. If you want your ears to be more upright, you're just going to have to play with them a little bit. And then, of course, we're going to take out the all the paper clips once everything's dry. So there's our bunny. We're all done. Yay! I hope your bunny came out good. So that's our bunnies. Now I just have a little bit more to say. Next Tuesday will be more of an adult, teen, adult type program. But younger kids can also help. We will be using a sharp edge, a razor blade, a Sharpie, a box cutter. That's why we need the adults. Once we get the stuff cut out, then the kids can paint it. So kids can help. It's just mom's going to have to work with them and the sharp object. You are going to need plastic bottles and some lights. We are going to change a string of lights into a garland of flowers. How are we going to do that? You'll have to come on Tuesday at 3 to find out. I also want to mention that I will be trying to do a Zoom tatting class. Tatting is lace making, and it's going to be Monday at 3 p.m. If you're interested, you need to send me your email address to beckertat853@gmail.com. And if you send me your email, I will send you back an invitation to my tatting class. For the tatting class, you will need a pair of scissors, a plastic lid, and some kind of string. This is crochet thread, thick crochet thread. That will work. Yarn probably won't work because we're sliding thread across each other. Tatting isn't something you can learn in one day. You will definitely need to practice. We're going to make a shuttle out of this, and that's how you're going to start learning to tat. I also teach these tatting classes in my craft programs at both Holloway Gonzales and the Northeast Branch Library. So once the library opens, you can come to my classes there. My craft classes are not age discriminative. I don't discriminate with age unless I'm using a sharp object. For tatting, I had a fourth grader come and she actually picked it up much faster than any of the adults I've tried to teach. So kids can come and do it. It's a great craft. You can usually carry it in a very small package if you're traveling, and it's a good way to spend your time. So Monday at 3, remember, email me at beckertat853@gmail.com if you would like an invitation to it. It will be on Zoom, so that I can answer questions as people get them, since I can't really answer questions on Facebook Live. And next Tuesday, we will be making a flower garland out of a string of Christmas lights. So come back and join me. That's all for today. Bye.